Sometimes some teachers, Bharaswam used to have 5-hour long classes, you know, sometimes. That's all. He would start in the morning and go on until 12 o'clock, you know. This Brahma, he will sit in one place, this Brahmachari, you know, will be up and down, these fellows, but anyway. So sometimes it goes around, there's no time is left for bhiksha. That's okay. So shravana adishesha kale dehasityartham. For sustenance of the body, in the time that remains after doing this shravanam and whatever else. Yajna shishta shina santaha muchyande sarvakilbishahi. Yajna shishta shina, meaning what? Those people who eat only that which is left over after performing all the yajnas. After giving share to everybody that, you know, there is to be given, then whatever remains upon that alone they sustain themselves. Similarly, these people sustain themselves in the time which remains after doing the shravanam, mananam, whatever is required, in the remaining time, remainder time alone, they may go for bhikshacharanam. Because bhikshacharyam charanam is what? This is what they do. That's all. They take to the life of mendicant. And that seems to be primary business. It's not primary business. It is only dehasthityartham, only for sustaining the body. Then Bhashyakara says, bhikshartham charanam, bhikshacharyam. So charanam also is wandering also, is not just out of pleasure, bhikshacharanam. That he goes out, you know, and so that also is not that he goes out just, you know, I mean wandering or whatever it is. He is going out also is for only bhiksha, that's all. The rest of the time, he is committed. Bhikshartham charanam, bhikshacharyam. So bhikshacharyam charande. Charandi kurvante, this is what they do. Then says Vashyakara, tyaktva smartam lingam. This paramahamsa parivrajaka means what? Tyaktva smartam lingam. He does not have any linga, or he does not have any insignia, or any mark at all, which the smriti requires. So smriti is enjoined that the person belonging to every given ashrama must have a particular kind of mark. A brahmachari should have a particular kind of a mark, by which he is distinguished as a brahmachari. Mekhala ajina dandena brahmachari tu lakshate. Mekhala ajina danda. Mekhala means a girdle. Ajinam means an animal skin. And danda means a staff. This is how you know that he is a brahmachari. Gruhastho deva yajnadehi nakalomna vanashritaha. How do you know he is a grahastha? Deva yajna adyahi. Then he performs deva yajna, etc. That is how you know a grahastha. That is his mark. So when you go to a person, if you find him performing deva yajna, etc., performing those rituals, propitiating devatas, you know that he is a grahastha. How do you know the vanaprastha? So nakalomna vanashritaha. Long hair, long nails, etc. Then you know that this fellow is a vanashritaha. He is a tapasvi. Vanashritaha, vanaprastha means what? He is tapasvi. He is performing, living a life of penance and austerities. So then, long hair, long nails, etc. This is how you know the vanaprastha. So, the smritikara desires that this is how everybody should be recognized. How do you know the sannyasi? Tridandena yatischeva. Yati is known by tridanda. Yati means a sannyasi is known by tridanda. You take three staffs, you know, thin sticks, and then join them into one, tie them into one rather, tie them and make one danda, but actually made up of three danda. That's called tridandi, sannyasi. Tridandena yatischeva. So yati is known only by tridanda. Then you know that this fellow is a yati. Otherwise, how do you know? He's otherwise a mlecha. If a person does not wear any mark, he is a mlecha. Or he's whatever. That's why he is discarded. Because people do not know how to relate. As I said, when you meet a person, how do you relate to him? Should you bow down to him? Or should he bow down to you? Or what should happen? How should you greet that person? How should you salute him? How should you treat him? How should you talk to him? How should you relate to him? How do you know? That you know by where he belongs, where he comes from, what he belongs to, which ashrama he belongs to. And how do you know which ashrama he belongs to? So as in Ramcharitmanas also, when Lord Rama went to Bharadwaj's ashrama, then Prayaga, then everybody came to know around that, hey, Dasharatha, sons of Dasharatha have come here. And there were all brahmacharis and gurastas and all sadhu-santas, all variety, they all came. Then Lord Rama should know that this fellow is a sadhu, he is a brahmachari. Then he did pranam to everybody, because he is a grahastha. And therefore, he actually saluted to everybody. That is his dharma. Then you will fail to follow your dharma if you do not recognize that person as brahmachari. He is a brahmachari, you fail to recognize him, and then you fail to greet him properly, then that is a dharma. All of that cannot happen, therefore, it is necessary. Yasaita lakshanam nasti prayaschettina chashrami. So, lakshanani prasak prasak. Every ashrama has prasak prasak lakshanani. Everybody has different lakshanas. And yasaita lakshanam nasti. The person who does not any one of the lakshana or insignia, prayaschetti na cha, he is not an ashrami. He doesn't belong to this fold of varnashrama dharma, prayaschetti. He is only prayaschetta yogya. For him you should perform prayaschetta, you know, to bring him to this fold of whatever, he does not belong to the fold. So varnashrama dharma is a very tight structure. And when you belong to that fold, then you must also live in a certain way. So this is what the smriti says. And therefore, according to that smriti, even a sannyasi also must have three dandas, you know, tridandi. So Mahasayakara says, tektva smartam lingam, openly, you know, challenging them, so openly combating with them, you know, tektva smartam lingam, even that also smarta lingam, is also to be given up. So Mahasayakara says things even that contradicts some of these smriti statements. So even that statement of smriti which is not in keeping with shruti is to be discarded. So then it is not a pramanam. Shruti is pramanam all right as long as it conforms to shruti. But here shruti says this. Shruti very clearly says that the mumukshus can renounce, and then if some shrutikara insists that everybody should have the insignia, Mahasayakara says no. That part of the smriti is not acceptable to us. So therefore deliberately this is being said here. Tyaktva smartam lingam. When we mean paramahamsa parivrajaka, that means that he does not have any linga or any insignia at all, which means that he does not belong to any varna ashrama. He doesn't have any duty of varna or ashrama. That's the idea. He is free from every duty. That's all. Footnote number 3, smartam lingam smrutyuktam tridandadirupam. That's what smriti says. So says Anandagiri, tridandena yatischeva ityari smrutehe. So this smriti, tridandena yatischeva lakshate, yatihi tridandena lakshate. Yati or a sannyasi is recognized by his mark of tridanda. Ityari smrutehe na paramahamsa parivrajyam atra vivakshitam. So somebody asks this question of Bhashyakara, and you are saying, so vyutthaya meaning paramahamsa parivrajyam pratipadya. Then the question is, look, the smritikara says that even a sannyasi also should have this mark of the nature of sridanda. Therefore, the kind of sannyasa referred to in the Shruti here is not paramahamsa sannyasa, but this tridandi sannyasi. Hamsa sannyasi, not paramahamsa. Iti ashankya, aha, tyaktva smartam lingam. Footnote number 9. Iti ashankya iti. Ashramantarani lakshayitva tridandeni yatischayvaiti mokshashram lakshayata dakshena. Daksha. Daksha means the Daksha Smriti. So this Daksha is anyway Smriti Kara. Of the 18 Smritis, there is Daksha Smriti. So by Daksha, Mokshashram Lakshayata Dakshana. So when Daksha gives here the Lakshana or the characteristic of the one belonging Mokshashram, so Sannyasi is the one who belongs to Mokshashram, all right. But then how does sage Daksha actually describe a person who has taken to mokshashramam in sannyasa? Tridandena yatischeivaiti mokshashramam lakshayata ashramantarani lakshayitva. Having given the characteristic of the people belonging to other ashramas, namely the brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha, then Daksha describes the lakshana of a person who has taken to the life of sannyasa for moksha. He says, tridandena yatischeiva lakshate. Yati is recognized by his staff, possess made up of three dandas. Dakshana. Shikha yajnyo pavitadi parityagarupam parivrajyam nirakratam. although I did not find this kind of thing in Lakshasmriti, this is there. Tridandayana yatischaiva lakshanani prathak prathak. But shikha yajno bhavitadi parityagarupam parivrajyam nirakratam. Maybe I go to study the whole smriti, I don't know. But from this, the understanding is when Daksha, so when sage Daksha says that even a yati also should have this tridanda, that means that sage Daksha also means that yati must have also a shikha and yajno bhavita. That even a sannyasi also should not give up shikha and yajno bhavita. That seems to be shikha yajno bhavitadi parityagarupam parivrajyam nirakratam. So apparently, Daksha Shruti seems to discard the sannyasa of parivrajyam, where the yajnopavita and shikha is given up. That kind of a sannyasa is discarded by Daksha. Meaning Daksha does not accept a sannyasa where you discard all these insignias. Ataha shikhadi shalinaha tridandinaha sarvasmriti prasiddhaha sannyasinaha. And therefore, sarvasmriti prasiddhaha. So all sannyasis which are well known in all the smritis are what? Shikhadi shalinaha. So those who are possessed of shikha, yajnopavita, etc., tridandinaha, and further possessing danda. So this is there for everybody. Then a brahmachari wears also a mekhala and wears an ajinam. A grahastha performs the deva yajna, etc. A vanaprastha has long hair and nails, and a sannyasi has tridanda. But shikha and yajnopavita is common for all the four. Except then, over and above that, person belonging to different ashramas have some further marks by which they are recognized. So shikha yajna bhavita is common. And then brahmachari is mekhala and ajinam. And grahastha is this, and vanaprastha is that, and sannyasi is this tridanda. Therefore it says shikha vishalinaha tridandinaha sarvasmriti prasiddhaha sannyasinaha. The sannyasis that are very well known in the smritis, meaning describe the smritis, are like this. They don't give up shikha and yajnopavita. Teshameva vitthayatyadivakya grahanam. And therefore, in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad also, when the Shruti says, vitthaya asa bhikshacharyam charandi, who are the people referred to? So, the Purupakshi says, or Shankituhu, the person who has his doubt, says that maybe the sannyasis is referred to even by the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, or the sannyasis described by Daksha and other smritikaras. And therefore, for you to say that this is Paramahamsa Parivrajya Lakshana Sannyasa is not right. So, aha. Okay, then, that aha is then you have to go to Anandagiri. That's where the aha is. Amukshatvacha tasya tyajyata iti aha. So, okay. Sita Anandagiri, tasya drashtarthatvat mumukshubhi tyajyatvam suchayati kevalam. Okay. So, Vashyakara says here, that tyaktva smartam lingam kevalam ashramatasharanam jivanasadhanam parivrajya abhivyanjakam or vyanjakam. So tasya, smarta lingasya. So Vashyakara says, why that linga is there? Why should a sannyasi or yati also have this tridanda? Drishtarthatvat mumukshubhi tyajyatvam. All of these is drishtartham. Meaning all these signs you are wearing because you want to accomplish something that is desirable. Drishtarthatvat. Mumukshubhi. Mumukshu does not want to accomplish even a brahmaloka. A person may take sannyasa because he wants brahmaloka. Even that also a mumukshu does not want. And therefore, tasya drishtarthatvat. So all the smartha lingas are meant to perform, to accomplish some drishtartha. Otherwise you don't get, you see the thing is, that if you perform your action as a grihastha without shikha yajna bhavita, then that yajna may fail to produce drishtartha. So yajna is supposed to produce a punya karma. But that punya karma will be produced by yajna only when you perform action as specified. And suppose you fail to have these marks, maybe shikha yajna bhavita, then the yajna will not produce a drishtam. And things like that. So, therefore, All of these marks are worn by people because they want to achieve something. Otherwise, you will deprive of that benefit. They all want benefit. So, everybody wants benefit for a given ashrama. And the person will be deprived of benefit if he does not conduct himself in accordance with what the code of conduct requires. So, for every ashrama, a code of conduct is required, so that the person belonging to the ashrama gains certain benefits. And those benefits, but mumukshu doesn't want those benefits. Tasya drishtarthatvat mumukshu bhi tyajyat pramdevam. Mumukshu does not even desire the benefit that this tridanda etc. has to give, and therefore mumukshu has to give up even that. It is suchayati. So Bhashyakar said, kevalam ashramatasharanam jivan sadhanam. Now this passage explained two ways. Now these fellows have taken these three dandas only because they want to pose as yatis, and so that they will be given this bhiksha etc. Ashramatasharanam jivan sadhanam, meaning that they have taken up this tridanda or this life of yati as a jivana sadhana. And mumukshu has not taken up this life as a jivana sadhana. So, kevalam ashramata sananam jivana sadhanam parivrajya vyanjakam. So, this tridanda etc., they no doubt parivrajya vyanjakam, that reveals the parivrajyam or renunciation. But what kind of renunciation is that? That renunciation is for sustenance of his life, and not the renunciation is for the purpose of moksha, etc. So that must be given up. Or kevalam ashramata sharanam jivana sadhanam ji parivrajya vyanjakam. Or here on the other hand, these people have taken up to parivrajya or renunciation because jivana sadhanam. All they desire from the renunciation, that life is nothing but jivana sadhanam, meaning sustenance of the body and nothing else. So there is nothing on them that is parivrajya vyanjakam. For other parivrajakas or yatis, the vyanjakam, so that which declares that the yatis is there, this person does not have anything that declares that he is a yati. So he need not even has to declare that he is a yati. The only thing that is bhikshacharanam is done only for jivana sadhanam. And so he has undertaken this life only to sustain the body, and nothing more than that he desires from this way of life. So that also one can look at that passage. This is Anandagiri. Amukhyatvacca tasya tyajyata ityaha. Amukhyatvat. That yati, that fellow is not mukhya. Yati na mukhya artha parivrajya vyanjakam. His tridanda is only parivrajya vanjakam. And so that he has taken up that life as for sustenance, so it is not sannyas in a mukhya sense, therefore also mumukshu should give up that. Aha. So that aha, you go to the tika now. Aha iti in the fifth line. Smartha sannyasasya shruti virodhena satyamevanasti iti ashayana brute ityartha. Smart sannyasasya shruti virodhena. See, the sannyas of the smruti, like tridanda etc., it contradicts what the shruti says here. Satyamevanasti, therefore that is not really sannyasa in a proper primary sense, because that kind of sannyasa contradicts the spirit of the shruti. Iti ashayana brute. So with that ashaya, Bhashyakara says, parivrajya vyanjakam. And so, that is only merely the revealer of parivrajyam, and not that the fellow is a parivrajaka in a primary sense. Uktami vartike. Mundo parigrahaschedi pratyaksha shruti vakyatah tadviruddham smuter vakyam napeksham durbalatvatah. Mundo aparigrahaschedi pratyaksha shruti vakyatah. This very Shruti, Pratyama Shruti clearly says, you don't require linga etc. Shruti says very clearly in her own words, mundaha, aparigraha, mundaha, one who is seven-headed, aparigraha, who has no possession at all. Ini pratyaksha Shruti vakyataha, tad viruddham smutehe vakyam na apeksham. And therefore, the vakya, the statement of Shruti, that contradicts the very clear statement of Shruti, should not be accepted. durbalatvataha na apeksham, and therefore, since that is durbalam, not supported by Shruti, therefore it should not be accepted, so Vartikara says. And therefore, Bhashyakara makes an exception, takes an exception here to those statements of Shrutis which contradict the spirit. Of course, they have read this Shruti also, and this is their interpretation. Vashyakara says, that's a wrong interpretation. The interpretation is, Vithayatha Bhikshacharyam Charanti. They have grown out of every desire. Then why should they have any insignia at all? Why should they have to conform? So everybody should conform. Vashyakara says, this fellow should not conform to any rules and regulations also. Because the self-conformation is there, understand? Of course, not that he leads a Swachanda life, but the self-motivation is there. The point is, why should you wear certain insignia and declare yourself so and so, when the motivation has to come from that Pashyanna Pichana Pashyari Muda, Jachiro Mundi Lunchita Kesha. So you take up to this way of life, or I mean this kind of the clothes and dresses, etc., so that it reminds you as to what you are. But suppose you don't require any kind of a reminder, then what? Then you need not even conform to or wear or show any kind of chinhas or insignias. So this is purely self-motivated person. Therefore, he doesn't have to declare who he is, nor does he require any reminder. So every time I take up danda, I am reminded. Every time I do something, I am reminded. That reminder does not require because he is a self-motivated person. That is a sannyasa in a primary sense. This sannyasa in a secondary sense, where motivation is not within, the motivation is come from without to some extent, then because other motivations are there. Because he wants to go to Brahmaloka, whatever other benefits sannyasa has to offer. And he wants those benefits. And so, it is prompted by those benefits that is done. But here, this is a sannyasa which is not prompted by any benefit at all. Here is a sannyasi who has renounced all the benefits and all the claims. And therefore, that's what this statement does not refer to this sannyasa. It may refer to sannyasa as an ashram, all right, but this sannyasa referred to here is not that sannyasa. This is the Paramahamsa Parivrajaka Lakshana sannyasa. This is a point that Bhashyakara wants to make. And says, Annagiri Tathabi, Tvarishtra sannyasa. Na smritikara hi nibaddha iti chet. All right. Tathabi. Tathabi means what? Footnote number 11. Shrauta vakshima sanyasa veksha smart sanyasa se durvalatvena amukhyatva tyajyatve vi tyarthaha. So shrauta vakshima sanyasa veksha, in giving the sanyasa, that is what is intended by the Shruti. Smart sannyasasya durvalatvena. There is a sannyasa that is referred to by the Shruti. It is not a mukhya sannyasa as compared to the sannyasa referred to by the Shruti. Therefore, durvalatvena. Smart sannyasasya durvalatvena. The sannyasa referred to by the Shruti is inferior kind of a sannyasi. Amukhyatvat tyajyatvevi. Amukhya sannyasi. And therefore, that kind of a sannyasa is given up here. Going to Anani, Tathabi, Tvadishtaha sannyasaha nasmritikarahi nibaddhaha Tathabi. All right. So the sannyasa that you talk, so the statement you quoted here of Daksha Smriti, etc., that sannyasa is not the sannyasa referred to here. But is this sannyasa that you are talking about, is it ever referred to by any smriti anywhere? Does it have any kind? So Shruti, ultimately you must find some smriti statement to explain the Shruti statement also. So at least the kind of sannyasa you are talking about, Paramahamsa Parivrajaka, that must have the consent or concurrence from some smriti. Tathavi tvadishtaha sannyasa na smritikarahi nibaddhaha. And so Paramahamsakya, where is that sannyasa we found anywhere in the smriti? Iti ched, if this is what you think, no. Even this Paramahamsa sannyasa also is described by the smritikaras vidvanadi. So Bhashyakara says, विद्वालिंगवर्जितः तस्मादलिंगः धर्मज्ञः अव्यक्तलिंगः अव्यक्ताचारः इत्यादि स्मृतिभ्यः. So no smriti is definitely say विद्वान लिंगवर्जितः. विद्वान, wise man is the one who is लिंगवर्जितः. who has no linga, no insignia at all, so no mark to reveal his vidvattam.
Tasmad alingaha, dharmagnyaha, avyaktalingaha, avyaktacharaha.
How should a sannyasi be?
Alingaha.
Without a linga or a marks,
dharmagnyaha, but one who knows the dharma,
avyaktalingaha, all his lingas are not evident.
Avyakta acharaha,
his achara of sannyasa is not evident.
Then he is sannyasi in the core.
So all whatever the lingas have actually to do, that already he has. Therefore, as we said, it does not require an external show or manifestation in order to be sannyasi. So his achara, he is spontaneously, so whatever the linga would demand of him, he already is. That is the reason why he doesn't have to wear the lingas.
Avyakta achara.
Even he doesn't make a show of any achara. That is, achara also is required that you must act in a certain way, under different conditions. Even that also he doesn't seem to show. But then, whatever spirit that achara is required, well, that spirit he already has. So therefore, when you go to a river, you must do pranama as you approach the river. And when you leave the river, again another pranama. And when you cross the river, then take the bath. All of these are specified, what you should do. And so, that even if you may find him not doing it. But anyway, whatever the spirit is there, that he already has. And therefore, avyakta acharaha, ityadi smriti bhyaha. These are the statements on the smriti.
Anandagiri says, pratyaksha shruti virodhaccha smarta sannyasaha mukhyona bhavati iti aha.
So not only that is a mention of the sannyas in the smritis, but shruti, of course, what the reason why all the discussion was warranted here is because this statement of Brihadaranyaka Upanishad does not clearly enjoin sannyasa and does not clearly say what kind of a sannyasa it is. That's the reason why Bhashyakara had to say that what is meant here or intended here is a sannyasa of Paramahamsa Parivrajaka type. But elsewhere Shruti clearly says, this sannyasi should be how? Elsewhere Shruti clearly says, pratyaksha shruti virodhaccha.
Footnote 13, pratyaksha shruti. Shrutya tanmula shruti anumanevi. Pratyaksha peksha durvalatvema anumayasya iti abhiprayaha.
The thing is, here Bhashyakara quotes a shruti statement to say that, see, Shruti very clearly says in her own words that one must be sannyasi without any chinha. Then somebody argues that, wait a minute. Generally it is taken for granted that all the statements of Shruti also have an origin from the Shruti. The Shrutikaras or the sages, they have not said things simply out of figment of their imagination, but whatever they have said in their Shruti must have a source in the Shruti someplace. Now what has happened is, many texts of the Veda, the Shrutis, are not available to us. And therefore, people are not able to trace every statement of Shruti to some Shruti statement. They are not able to trace. Then what do you do? Should you say that this Shruti must be discarded? Any Shruti bhakyaha smrutayaha, any Shrutis that are outside the pale of the Shruti must be discarded. So suppose you do not find a corresponding statement of Shruti to corroborate with the Shruti statement, should we discard it? We give a benefit of doubt to Shrutikara, that there must be some Shruti statement which that Shrutikara knows, which is not available to us. So that is what the footnote says. Shrutya tanmula shruti anumanevi. See, Daksha Shruti describes sannyas in a certain this way, therefore we must infer that there must be a mula shruti, a original shruti from which this statement comes. Anumanevi. Pratyaksha apeksha durbalatvaiva anumayasya. But then, anything that you infer is always weaker than what you see. So what you see is always stronger than what you infer. So what Daksha Smriti says, has, even if it has the origin in the Shruti, there is something by way of inference. But here we find a Shruti that is pratyaksha or clear, so that anumaya Shruti is weaker than the pratyaksha Shruti. Therefore, what the pratyaksha Shruti says here, has to be taken, another one must be discarded. So, therefore, Anandagiri says, pratyaksha shruti virodha. There is anumeya shruti. In that sense, it is said, pratyaksha shruti. Virodhacha smarta sannyasa mukhyona bhavati. Therefore, that smarta sannyasa
or sannyasa talked about in the Shruti is not mukhya sannyasa. Ityaha athayati. So Vashyakara says, atha parivrad vivaranavasaha mundaha aparigraha ityadishrutehe sashikhan keshan nikritya visrudya yajnopavitamiti cha cha shrutehe. This is also shruti. Atha parivrad vivaranavasaha, meaning what? Vigara shveda varanam kashayam ityartha. So vivaranavasaha, vivaranavasaha means, so vivarana shveda varanam, he doesn't have shveda varana. Kashayam ityartha, that means he wears kashaya vastra, he doesn't wear shveda vastra, etc. Mundaha, shaven headed, aparigraha, does not possessing anything, ityadi shrutehe. Or another one. So, sashikhan keshan nikritya. Sashikhan keshan nikritya. Shikhan, you know, that is also sashikham. So, nikritya means removing the hair, clipping the hair along with the tuft. Visrudya yajnopavitam and discarding the yajnopavita. Iti cha, this is what Kathashruti says. Kathashruti is not Kathopanishad. Kathashruti is a shruti coming from that Kathashakha of the Vedas. So there are this Katha Brahmana and then these others, the Brahmanas and Aranyakas are there belonging to Katha Shaka. Iti cha. Iti cha Shrutehe. So that Shruti very clearly says, openly says, therefore, sannyasa referred to here is Paramahamsa Parivrajaka sannyasa and not the Amukhya sannyasa or sannyasa in a secondary sense as referred to by the other Shrutis. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Takeya Papracha Yajnavalkye Deho Vacha Yadeva Sakshad Aparokshad Brahma Yatma Sarvantaraha Tamme Vyachakshveti Eshata Atma Sarvantaraha Katamo Yajnavalkya Sarvantaraha Yoshanaya Pipase Shokam Moham Jaram Ratyumatyeti Etam Vaitam Atmanam Viditva Brahmana Putra Ishanayascha Vitta Ishanayascha Loka Ishanayascha Vitthaya Atha Bhiksha Charyam Charande Yahyeva Putra Ishanasa Vitta Ishana Ya vittaishana sa lokaishana Uveshyete eshane eva bhavatah Tasmad brahmana panditya nirvidya balyena tishthased Tasmad
बाल्यं च पांडित्यं च निर्विद्या समुनिः अमौनं च मौनं च निर्विद्या सब्राह्मणः सब्राह्मणः केन स्यात् येन स्यात् येन स्यात् तेनेदुष एव अतोऽन्यदार्थम् ततोह कहोलः कौशीतकेय उपरराम भाष्यकार इज कमेंटिंग अपॉन व्युत्थाय अथ ब्रह्मचर्याम चरन्ति And it is said that this is a vidhi, meaning that Shruti in fact enjoins that one should renounce, having grown out of these desires, etam tam, etam vetam atmanam viditva, eshana away from various eshanayas, one has grown out, and then one should take to the rally for life of renunciate. Paramhamsa parivrajyam pratipadya, that's the sannyasa renunciation of the nature of highest order. स्मार्तम् त्यक्त्वा स्मार्तम् लिंगम् केवलम् आश्रमातृष्णानाम् जीवन साधनम् सो स्मार्तम् लिंगम् त्यक्त्वा सो दैट विच इज जीवन साधनम् सो दैट विच मेरली रिवील्स आश्रम दैट लिंग लाइक त्रिदंड त्रिदंड एटसेट्रा गिविंग अप दोज आल्सो मीनिंग इवन दैट काइंड ऑफ एन एग्जिबिशन आल्सो इज नॉट नेसेसरी और देयर इज नो नीड फॉर हिम टू असर्ट दैट ही इज अ सन्यासी व्हाट एवर विद्वान लिंग वर्जितः बिकॉज विद्वान वाइज मैन इज वन who is devoid of any linga or any insignia. Tasmada lingaha, dharmagnyaha, avyakta lingaha, avyakta acharaha ityadi smritibhyaha. This is what the smriti say, that he is alingaha, dharmagnyaha, avyakta lingaha, avyakta acharaha. Meaning his linga achara, nothing shows up. So he doesn't have to do anything particular, doesn't wear anything particular, doesn't do anything particular in order to display that he is a sannyasi. That's all. He may get displayed in a different way, it's a different matter, but that he does not have to do anything specific or does not have to wear any specific insignia in order to demonstrate or display, that is a sannyasi. Atha parivrat, vivaranavasaha, mundaha, aparigraha ityadi shrutehe. This is what Vartikara said, mundo parigrahaschedi pratyaksha shruti vakyatah. तद्विरुद्धं स्मृतिर्वाक्यं नापेक्षं दुर्बलत्वतः दिस वेन दिस प्रत्यक्ष श्रुति वाक्य इज देयर वेयर अनुमान एटसेट्रा इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड देन देयर इज नो नीड दैट यू टू एक्सेप्ट दैट स्मृति वाक्य व्हिच एंजॉइन्स वन टू वेयर सर्टेन इंसिग्निया दैट इज नॉट नेसेसरी स शिखान केशान निकृत्य विसृज्य यज्ञोपवीतमिति एंड दस क्लिपिंग ऑफ द हेयर along with the tuft, and Visruddhya Yajna Upavitam, even discarding the sacred thread, this is how the another Shruti describes the sannyasa. On the page 807, Sri Ranadagiri in this last line, etam veda vityadi vakyasya vidhayagatvam upetya. Vidhayagatvam meaning, that is the sense of enjoyment. Vyutthaya atha bhikshacharyam charandi. In fact, there is no state. That doesn't really grammatically mean that they are actually enjoining a person to, or instructing, or directing, or commanding that he must take sannyasa, even though grammatically that sense does not come out. But that sense has been brought on based on the whole, on the overall context. Because there is something that has to happen in order for the knowledge to take place. And since Bhashyakara says, Panditya Nirvidya Asabalya Netishtha said, all this Panditya Balyam, or Maunam, all of this is possible only when renunciation of this nature is there, otherwise it is not possible. So, Vidhayakatvam Upayatyasi, footnote number 14. Vyutthayatyam shasya sanyasa vidhayakatvam Vyutthaya atha bhikshacharyam charanti. So, Vyutthaya, having arisen from desires. So that part, vithaya, sannyasa vidhayakatvam, svikritya. So Bhashyakara accepts that vithaya is actually vidhanam or an enjoyment of sannyasa. So Uttaya grammatically just says, so having Uttanam Krutva, so having arisen, having renounced, having given up the desires. So you can say Vittishthanti, they arise from the desires. Or Vittishthantu, may they actually renounce. So this is how you have to convert that grammatically. Vittaya may have to be read as Vittishthantu, meaning that they should actually renounce. So Vittaya iti amsasya sannyasa vidhayakatvam. That Vittaya, that part, so that's part of the statement actually enjoins sannyasa. Bhikshacharyam charanditi amsasya tad dharma vidhayakatvam. Alright, so he has done the vithanam, alright. So what is the dharma? So what dharma does he have to follow now? So in keeping with this bhikshacharyam charan, that statement, Bhashyakara said that tyaktva smartam lingam, even all the linga also giving up and doing bhikshacharanam merely as a way of sustaining the life and nothing else. So only dharma. So dharma means a specific acharanam or a conduct that he must perform is really nothing other than sustaining his body by bhikshacharanam. Of course, this panditya, balyam, and nirvita, you know, maunam, all of this is his dharma, no doubt. But as far as his dharma in terms of the conduct or the karma is concerned, bhikshacharyam charati iti amsasya tad dharma vidhayakatvam, bhikshacharyam charanti, that's all. So this is dharma. That's all the dharma or the achara that they follow. Iti dharma vidhayakatvam, praudhya svikritya. Praudhya is praudhi. It is a bold assertion actually. Something which may not be there or may, you know, but then you assert. So like Sureshwaracharya would assert that the sannyasa, even though Bhashyakara very clearly says brahmananam eva sannyasa adhikaraha, that all brahmanas by jati alone are, according to Bhashyakara, qualified for sannyasa, still Bhartikara insists that no, brahmana, he stands for all the three varnas. This is the assertion. So that is a pravadhivadaha. And so he boldly asserts, sort of going over what has been accepted by the old people or by accepted people, going beyond that or asserting something that transgresses that. So here also pravadhya, if that is the meaning of the pravadhi, then there is an assertion here that vyuttaya should be understood in the sense of vidhi and bhikshacharanam. Is the only dharma. Therefore, not only this is a sannyasa, but this is a paramahamsa parivrajya lakshana sannyasa. This is how. So going back to Anandagiri, etam vai tam ityadi vakyasya vidhayakatvam upetya. Accepting that this vakya actually enjoins sannyasa, sarva karma tat sadhana parityaga paratvam uktam. And so Bhashyakara said, sarva karma tat sadhana parityaga paratvam. That one should renounce not only all the karma, but the sadhana. By sadhana was meant shikha and yajnopavita, etc. So all of that sadhanam, which are the requirement for performance of rituals, all of them should also be given up. Iti uktam. So this is what has been said. So parityaga paratvam vakyasya etam vaitam atmanam viditva, that vakya in fact enjoins one to renounce and giving up all the rituals, all the responsibilities or kartavya, along with all the insignia and means of that karma, all of that must be renounced. This is the meaning of that vakya. This is what Bhashyakara has said. Akshipati, somebody questions that. Wait a minute. So somebody questions this conclusion. Akshipati, nanu iti. So says the Bhashya there. Nano vyuttaya atha bhikshacharyam charante iti vartamana padeshad arthavadoyam navidhayakah pratyah kaschit shruyate linglord tavyana manyatamope. Tasmad arthavada matrena shrutismuti vihitanam
यज्ञोपवीतादीनां साधनानां न शक्यते परित्यागः कारयितुम्।
ननु व्युत्थायात् भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति इति वर्तमान उपदेशात्। This उपदेश और उपदेश is वर्तमानम्। भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति, that is in the present tense. So, having renounced, then they take to the life of mendicant. This is what is a description of an happening, that is a description of happening.
So, vartamana padeshat,
I am arthavada. This is merely an arthavada. Footnote number 6, bhuta arthavada. This is merely a statement of something that happens or that has happened. That's all.
Na vidhayaka kaschit pratyaya shvete.
We do not find any pratyaya or any suffix added to the verb which would be vidhayaka, meaning that would convey the sense of enjoyment or direction or command.
Ling lord tavya manyatamobi.
So ling lord tavya. So these are the pratyas that one or the other pratyas is generally employed in order to convey the vidhana, in order to convey direction. So, vittishthantu or vittishtheyuhu, something like that they should have said, you know, ling. Or vittishthantu, so that would be lot, and vittishtheyuhu. We don't find vittaya asa bhikshacharyam charandi, they just take to the life of mendicant, therefore, not that actually. So, bhikshacharyam chareyuhu, bhikshacharyam charantu, so, then charitavyam, whatever. So, this kind of construction is there, then we know that this is actually an enjoyment. But we don't find.
So, ling lord tavyanam anyatamavi pratyaya kastit nas vidhayakah. This is called vidhayakah pratyaya.
A pratyaya or suffix that actually is in the sense of direction or enjoyment or command. That should be command, then you must do that. And we do not find any grammatical suffix which will convey this particular sense. And therefore, we say that this is merely a statement of happening rather than an enjoyment or a command on the part of the Shruti.
Tasmad arthavada matrena.
So this is arthavada or anuvada. This is what happens or happened, you know, to some people.
Tasmad arthavada matrena. Shruti shruti vihitanam yajnopavitadinam sadhananam na shakyare parityagah kalpayitum. Tasmad, therefore. Vidhayaka abhavat.
Since we do not find any vidhayaka or any statement of command or enjoyment, therefore, you cannot parityaga karaitum nashakyare. You cannot make people give up things. Karaitum. You are making people give up their yajnopavita, shikha and everything else. And shruti shruti vihitanam. That wearing of the yajnopavita and also keeping a shikha, etc., all of this is enjoined by Shruti, Shruti, Vihitanam. That Shruti and Shruti are very clear that you must have this. So there Vidhana meaning command is there. There are commands from the Shruti as well as Shruti that one must have this chinha or insignia of the nature of Yajnopavita Shikha.
So that command you want to overcome, overlook. And here there is no command.
So where the command is not there, you are in fact imagining a command. And where the command is there, elsewhere, that is what you say, give them up. And so, you can't make people give up these things. Even so, when there is no specific sentence here, or pratyaya here, or suffix here, to actually mean in the sense of command.
Then says Anandagiri, itascha yajnopavitam aparityajyamiti
itascha. For this further reason also, yajnopavita should not give up. So there is a tremendous amount of here, an insistence as to how Yajnopavita etc. must be there, itascha. For this further reason also, Yajnopavitam aparityajyam, it must not be given up.
So says Bhashya, so Yajnopaviti eva iti. Yajnopaviti eva adhita yajayeda yajetava.
Yajnopaviti eva. Only the one who wears Yajnopavita or a sacred thread, he alone.
Adhigita. Adhigita means what?
So Vedan, Adhigita. He alone should study the Vedas, no one else.
Yajayet.
Yajeta, yajeta. He alone can perform the yaga, yajet. He alone can actually preside over or perform for someone else. So he alone can preside over yaga, make someone else perform the yaga, or himself perform the yaga. So he alone can act as a priest, or he alone can act as a yajamana, or he alone can actually study the Vedas, one who wears yajnopavita. This is very clear. Yajnopaviti eva. Excluding everybody other than yajnopaviti. Yajnopaviti means one wearing yajnopavita. That is why yajnopavitam aparityajyam. Therefore, yajnopavita should not be given up. Then says Anandagiri.
Yajanadi samabhivyaharat asanyasvishameta vidyashanke.
We will say, wait a minute. How do you say that this is a sentence meant for a sannyasi? He wants to say that a sannyasi also, Shruti say that sannyasi also should wear yajnopavita. That is something that should never be discarded. So in support of that is Vakya state. Now here, Yajanadi Samavivyaharat. As you said, Samavivyahara means stating together. And so, utterance, simultaneous utterance.
Yajanadi Samavivyaharat. So Adhiyeta, Yajayeta, Yajeta.
So wait a minute. Presiding over a ceremony or performing a yaga, all of this is not a sannyasi. So how do you say that this statement that is just quoted is meant for a sannyasi?
Yajanadi samavyaharat asanyas vishamedada.
The vakya that you have quoted, it doesn't have sannyasi as a vishaya, is not directed to sannyasi, appears to be directed to asanyasi, meaning one who is not a sannyasi.
Footnote number 8. Yajnopavita kartruka adhyana bodhi vakyam,
meaning this particular vakya, which says that adhyayana, etc. can be performed only by the one who wears yajnopavita, that vakya is not meant for sannyasi, because that vakya says he alone should study and he alone should perform yaga, etc. Naturally, sannyasi doesn't perform yaga and doesn't preside over the yaga. So, this sentence is not meant for sannyasi. So, we may say, then he says, parivrajyatavadati, then the Purupakshi says, quotes some further things, you know, here, from the Shrutis and Smritis.
Parivrajyetavata adhyayanam vihitam.
See, in parivrajya also, meaning for a renunciate also, adhyayanam, study of the Veda is something that is enjoined even for a renunciate. He may have renounced everything else, but he should never renounce Vedas. So Vedas should never be renounced. So parivrajyetavata adhyayanam vihitam. And so, that sentence, yajnopaviti eva adhiyita. That adhyayanam is meant for whom? For a renunciate also, because adhyayanam of the study of the Veda is something that should never be given up. And in support of that, the vakya that quoted,
Veda sanyasanat shudraha tasmat vedam na sanyased iti Swadhyaya evo chrujyamanaha vacham iti cha apastambaha brahmojham vedanindacha kautasaksham suhrudvadaha garhitanadya yor jagdhihi Surapana samanishata iti veda parityage dosha shravana
iti veda parityage dosha shravana. In all of the statements from the Shruti and the Smriti, veda parityage, if one gives up Veda, discards Veda, dosha shravana, how that fellow actually incurs a lot of sin? Or so what blemishes are there when one gives up the Veda? So Veda should never be given up. And if the Veda is not given up, if the study of the Veda continues, that means Yajnopavita also should not be given up.
So Veda sanyasana shudraha shudraha.
By giving up the Veda, discarding Veda, one becomes shudra. That's all. He becomes shudra.
Tasmad vedam na sanyase didi.
Therefore one should never give up the Vedas.
Then swadhyaya eva.
See, footnote number 3, Svadhyayeva ityadi. Yatra Svadhyaya adhyayana uchita samaya. Svadhyaya means adhyayana uchita samaya. A samaya of the time which is conducive for study of the Vedas or repeating Vedas.
Svadhyaya utsrujjamanah.
So tatrabi veda dhyanam sanyasan shudro bhodi ityartha. There also it means that if one gives up the Vedas, study the Vedas or reciting Vedas, then one becomes shudra.
Utsrujjamanah means tejan. Vacham means vedam.
So svadhyaya eva utsrujjamanah vachamitu apastambha. Apastambha. This is again apastambha sutra.
So says that
vacham utsrujjamanah. Vacham means vedam. Vedam utsrujjamanah. One who is given a veda.
Svadhyaya eva.
Even for that also, yes, for the, there must be enough time or adequate time must be there for svadhyaya. Meaning adhyana uchita samayaha. And so one should actually give up the, must have time for the study of Veda.
So vacham utsrujjamanah means what?
Here it says Vedam, but it is a vacham utsrujjamanah. So you must give up talking everything else and svadhyayavah. Svadhyayavah, then one must perform the svadhyaya. That also can be the meaning of the vakya.
Vedon ka tyag karne wale ko bhi svadhyaya ke liye uchit samay nikalna chahiye.
Vedon ka tyag, when you give up the Veda, then what is svadhyaya? But anyway, so even if you are given a Veda, meaning that further study is given up, then also the recital must be there. So,
svadhyaya utsrujjamanah vachamichya iti cha apastambha.
The idea is Veda parityaga dosha shravanam is there. So, Veda parityaga should not be done. That's all here. And therefore, this sentence also is meant to say that the vacham of Veda must not be given. That's why the footnote number 3 said, tatrabe veda dhyam sanyasan shudra bhodi. So one who gives up the veda dhyanam becomes a shudra.
Or then, manusmati.
Brahmojjham vedanindacha kautasakshyam suhrudvadha
garhitanna or garhitana adyayor jaddihi garhita anadyayoho.
That is how the footnote explains that actually.
Jagdhi surapan samanishad.
The six are considered to be sins comparable to drinking of alcohol.
Or manu, I guess, surapana must be the highest sin, you know. So, surapana.
So, drinking of alcohol apparently seems to be a tremendous sin. Because it is compared to brahmojjam.
So, meaning giving up the Veda, Vedaninda, Kautasakshyam, Surudvadaha.
So, see footnote number 6, brahmojjamiti.
Atra brahmojjara vedanindayati chakara rahitam patham. Brahmojjita vedaninda kautasaksham surutvadha, that can be an alternative reading here.
So what is brahmojjita?
Brahmojjita or brahmojjam, either way, same thing.
So
adhita vedasya anabhyasena vismaranam brahmojjita.
What is brahmojjita? Brahma means Veda. So actually, adhita vedasya, one who has studied the Veda, anabhyasena vismaranam, having studied the Veda and then forgetting because you do not practice that reciting, as good as killing a Brahmana, that is as good as Brahmahatya actually. So, forgetting the Vedas is looked upon as a sin which is comparable to Brahmahatya. Killing Brahma there means Veda, Brahma also means Brahma. So whatever kind of sin you may incur by killing a Brahmana is a sin that you incur by forgetting the Veda, neglecting the Veda studies.
That is Brahmojjita.
What is Vedaninda? Says,
Asat-shastra-shravanena Vedakutsanam Vedaninda.
Asat-shastra-shravanena. This fellow falls in bad company and listens to all kinds of other shastras, you know, like Charvaka, etc. And then Vedaninda, Vedakutsanam. Or that means that there are many Nastikas who do not accept Veda as the Pramanam, and you fall in company of them, or you study those Shastras, or listen to them, and come under their influence, and then you yourself start actually criticizing Vedas.
That Vedaninda, Vedakutsanam, Vedaninda.
So criticizing, or blaming, or censoring the Vedas is called Vedaninda. Very tremendous sin.
Kauta Sakshyam.
Sakshe mrishabhidhanam kautasaksham. So being a false witness. So when you are, so that all of this must be going on from time beginningless, you know. Not that the corruption or all of this is only present, I think. It's a matter of degree. It's a matter of intensity. But The fact that Manusmriti also talks about all these things, Kauta Sakshyam, etc. And therefore, you are presented as a Sakshi, and then you are invited as a Sakshi, and you tell a lie. So, Kauta Sakshyam.
Mrishabhidhanam,
telling a lie. Then, Garhita Suhrudvadaha Abrahmanasya Mitrasya Vadaha Suhrudvadaha. So, Mitrasya Vadaha Suhrudvadaha. Killing a friend. If you kill a friend who is Brahmana, then it is of course the Brahmahatya. But if you kill a friend who is not a Brahmana, it is called Suhrudvadaha. The Surapanam is equivalent to killing a friend, you know, imagine. So, anyway, then Garhita Anadyayoho Jagdhi. Eating something that is Garhita. Garhita means that which has been actually censured by the scriptures, you know. Garhidam Nishiddham Lashunadi. And so Lashunadi, what is it? This garlic, etc., which is prohibited. So prohibited food. Eating that is a tremendous sin, apparently. Anadyam Purishadi, and eating something that is also, you know, all of the Jagdhi. So that means that kind of eating is also tremendous sin. Medhatisistu na bhojyam maya tadi sankalpya yad bhujyade tad anadyam iti vyasaste. Another meaning the word anadyam. Anadyam is that we should not be eaten. So another meaning of the word that we should not be eaten is na bhojyam maya tad. I am not going to eat that. It is sankalpya yad bhujyade tad anadyam. You say, I am not going to eat this ice cream, and then I keep on eating every night, you know, or on every occasion. All is anadyam. I having made a sankalpa that I am not going to eat something, and then I eat, is a tremendous sin. It is comparable to suhrudvadha, which is, you know, so imagine. So what an amount of sin one has to perform to oblige people to eat things for which one has taken a sankalpa that I am not going to eat. And therefore, because of this idiotic insistence, you know, that somebody should eat because everybody else eats, then we are actually subjecting people for this kind of sins, you know, anyway. So, how many births one has to take because of that's a different matter, but anyway. So, sankalpya. Na bhojyam mayatadi sankalpya. Yad bhujyate tad anadyam. And so, that is the, having done the sankalpa, and then one eats, that's called anadyam. Tayoho jagdhi, jagdhi means bhakshanam. Iti manuvachanartha. So, anyway, eating that stuff is, that is surapana sama. Surapana means nothing these days anyway, but all of these are looked upon as sins comparable to surapanam. All of this is the applicable portion here. He is only brahmojjama, brahmojjita. Or that is discarding, giving up the Veda is what is the is intended portion here. The whole verse is quoted with so many other sins for our general information, but then for the particular thing that is applicable here is brahmojjita anyway. And so, iti Veda Parityage Dosha Shramanat. That Veda Parityage, given the Vedas, involves such an amount of dosha. Okay. So that is the Veda Tyage Dosha Shrutehe. Then further, okay. Veda Tyage Dosha Shrutehe, we saw, right? That we hear. Here means, Shravanam here means, Shrutam means, so Shrutya or Smrutya Pratipaditam. So Shruti or the Smriti clearly say what dosha or defect or blemish or sin is involved in discarding Veda, alright. Vedatyage dosha shrutehe tadatyage bhi, alright. So one should not discard or give up Veda, alright. Kadam parivraja yajnopavita, alright. Suppose we will not give up Veda. But why do you insist that a parivrajaka should continue to put on this yajnopavita? All right, Veda Parityaga will not do. Kadam Parivrajya Yajnopavita Miti Ashinkya. Still Pura Paksha is going on, and so we ask him, all right, why do you insist that Yajnopavita must be there? Shikha must be there. Why? Upasane. Then he further quotes here. Upasane Gurunam Vriddhanam Atithinam Home, Japya Karmani, Bhojane, Achamane, Swadhyaye cha, Yajnopaviti Syat, Iti
परिव्राजक धर्मेषु च गुरुपासन स्वाध्याय भोजनाचमनादीनां कर्मणां श्रुतिस्मृतिषु कर्तव्यतया चोदितत्वात् गुरुवादी उपासनांगत्वेन यज्ञोपवीतस्य विहितत्वात् तत्परित्यागः नैवावगन्तुं शक्यते। So all right, in another way he brings about, you know, so there are different ways of insisting or asserting how Yajnopavita Shikha is required. So you find some other statement from some other place. Upasane, Guru Nam. Before that, later on, then that says, Idi Parivrajaka Dharmeshuja Guru Upasana Swadhyaya Bhojana Ashmanadinam Karmanam Sudhismritishu Kartavyadaya Choditatvat. First of all, even for the sannyasis also, certain karmas are enjoined by the Shruti and Smriti. What are they? Guru Upasanam, so serving the teacher. Swadhyaya, study of the Vedas. Bhojana, he should at least eat his food. Achamanam, rinsing his mouth. Karmanam, so that is also enjoyment, you know. Because that also people may not do, who knows, you know, and so what? Anyway, Achamanadinam, so Karmanam, Shruti Smriti Kartavyadaya, Vihitattva, Choditattva. So in the Shruti and the Smriti, all these karmas or all these duties or rituals, you know. So all of this is enjoined even for a parivrajaka, you know, just because you are sannyasi does not give license to a dirty fellow, whatever it is, you know. And therefore, this must be done. So Guru Upasanam, serving the teacher. And the teacher will refuse to be served, you know, by a person who doesn't follow these other things, you know. So anyway, so Swadhyaya, Bhojana, Ashmanadinam, Karunam, Shruti Smritishu Kartavyadaya Choditattvat. Swami Dayanandi used to have a lot of problems. There were so many brahmacharis and many people want to serve, you know. As soon as the fellow enters the room, Swamiji has a problem, you know. Until he leaves the room, you know. And so, until then, he has a tremendous problem. You know? He has to take bath or something like that later on when the person leaves. Because that fellow may not take bath or whatever it is, or whatever the reason may be. But then, sometimes, this kuseva also can happen anyway. That's why these things are enjoined. That the person who does seva also must follow a certain minimum of achara, you know. So, parivrajaka dharmeshu. So, while describing dharma or the duty of parivrajaka, even of a renunciate, that guru upasanam, the serving the teacher, swadhyaya, study the Veda. So, swadhyaya is a part of it. Bhojanam, ashamanam, all of these karmas are actually choditam, meaning enjoined. Suppose I enjoined, so what? Then it says earlier, upasane guru nam vriddhanam atithi nam hom. So upasane, when you want to serve the guru or vriddha or atithi, in all of those, then home you want to perform homa. Japya karmani, you want to perform japa. Bhojane, you are eating your food. Achamane, rinsing the mouth. Swadhyaya cha, studying the Vedas. Yajnopaviti syat. Only Yajnopaviti, one wearing Yajnopavita can perform this karma, that's all, nobody else, you know. That's why they say this is our Maharaj, you know, at he was serving some place. And they had a guest, you know, some Karmakandi Brahmana had come from somewhere, you know, from North India or some place. And then he asked, who is cooking food here? He said, this Maharaj. So he called this, are you wearing Yajnopavita? He says, no. Are you doing Sandhyavandan? He says, no. Forget it, I won't eat food cooked by you. So therefore, the fellow was initiated by him, you know, into doing these things and then japa, etc. Then he says, okay, now I will eat your food. So even Brahmana alone is not enough. Ramaswami will examine, you know, whether this Brahmana is a Brahmana or not, you know. So whether he wears sacred thread and then does he have the qualification of a Brahmana, I mean, or insignia of a Brahmana also or not. Sab achar nahi ra, kuch achar raha nahi abhi, you know. So really, every time he comes, he laments, you know. That achara bhi raha nahi hai. And meaning thereby that people like this Swami should actually propagate this achara. Varnashrama dharma nahi raha hai. South mein bhi nahi raha hai. Varnashrama dharma kahan raha hi nahi hai. So we can see, so according to them, or according to him and maybe people like him, all the problems that we have in India is all because of this. This dharma is given up, you know.
Somebody told me in United States, some priest from Andhra said that Americans are all miserable, unhappy, there is so much conflict because all their houses are built not according to Vastu Shastra. That's all. Because the kitchen must be in this direction and this bathroom must be in another direction and the entrance must be in a different... They're all wrong. That is why they can never be happy. So that was his conclusion. But anyway, this shows tremendous Shraddha. The idea is that this is a tremendous Shraddha in the scriptures. And all of the discussion also here is taking into account the Shraddha. So Bhashyakara wants to address this. Merely interpreting this statement as an enjoyment of sannyasa, and on the strength of that inference on your part to discard everything which is enjoyed by the Shruti and the Smriti, so does it mean that he has no Shraddha in the Shruti and the Smriti, other statements or what? So this kind of an interpretation on the part of Bhashyakara, does it show a lack of Shraddha? That is why these statements are quoted here. Now look, you are asking people to do something which totally seems to contradict what is stated in the Shruti and the Smriti. How can you ask them to do that? See, this is what is stated. So Bhashyakara takes this into account, meaning that in spite of all of this is being stated, in spite of these things being stated in the Shruti and the Smriti, still there is a case for renunciation of the nature of discarding all insignias. That there is a state, or there comes a state, or there has to be a state, where all these insignias are given up. Therefore, these are all deliberately presented as Purupaksha. Bhashyakara does not shy away from the scriptures or from addressing every aspect of the scripture. Whatever came to Bhashyakara's notice, then subsequent teachers came and then they addressed other things also, which subsequently cropped up by way of doubts and Purupakshas, etc. But whatever can possibly arise as a doubt or as an objection, all of these are dealt with by Bhashyakara. Not that he merely asserts and says, don't argue. So all arguments are presented, and presented by people who have exposure to the scriptures. And this is deliberately presented in order, as we said, to resolve or to understand what is the scope of the different statements of Shruti and Smriti, who are they addressed to, you know. So going back to Bhashya, Iri Parivrajika Dharmeshucha, Guru Upasana Swadhyaya Bhojanachamana Dinam Karmana Shruti Smriti Shu Kartavyataya. Should be not Kartavyata. Although Karmanam Kartavyata, Karmanam Kartavyata, then should be Kartavyataya Choditattvat. So Kartavyataya Choditattvat is better. Not Kartavyata, but Kartavyataya Choditattvat. Guruvadi Upasanangatvena Yajnopavitasya Vihitattvat. Even if you say that a Parivrajika should only serve his teacher, let us say, that is accepted. That Vividisha Sannyasi definitely serves the teacher. But for serving the teacher also, Yajnopavidi eva syat, only Yajnopavidi, one wearing Yajnopavida alone can serve the teacher. So Yajnopavidasya vihitatvat tat parityagaha naiva avagantum shakyade endeavor. Parityagaha, discarding of this Yajnopavida, avagantum naiva shakyade. We cannot see how that can ever be the conclusion, or that is what we can ever understand from that. We cannot. So Anandagiri says on the page 808, Upasana idi anena vakyena guruvadi upasana angatvena yajnopavitasya vihitatva idi anena vakyena. So by the Vakya, Upasana, Guru Nama, so by that Vakya, Guruvadi Upasanangatvena Yajnopavitasya Vihitatvat. See, Yajnopavita is something that is enjoined as a part or as a requirement for the serving the teacher, etc. Parivrajika Dharmeshu Guru Upasadinam Kartavyataya Sruti Smritishu Choditatvat. So this statement is different. And other, see, one thing is, the Shruti and the Smriti is enjoined that even a Parivrajika also should serve the teacher, should do the Swadhyaya, should take his meals, Bhojanam and Achamanam, etc. These are enjoined as dharmas for Parivrajika in the Shruti and Smriti. Elsewhere, the Shruti would say that for the one who performs, who serves the teacher and who does all this, he must be Yajnopaviti. For elsewhere it is said, that means that the person serving the teacher must have Yajnopavita. And in Parivrajya Dharma, for renunciate, the Guru Upasana, etc. are enjoined, that means that he should also wear Yajnopavita. So in one place, the scripture enjoins that for a renunciate also, these duties are a must. Elsewhere it is enjoined, the one performing the duties must wear Yajna Bhavita. That means that a renunciate also should wear. This is how he connects. There may not be a direct statement for a renunciate to wear Yajna Bhavita, but he should do this, and for the one who does it, he must wear the Yajna Bhavita. Therefore it amounts to saying that even a renunciate also should have Shikha, Yajna Bhavita, etc.
So iti anena vakyena guru adupasanangatvena yajnopavitasya vihitatvat. So upasane gurunam, up to that point yajnopavitisyad, up to that point by that vakya, since yajnopavita is something that is enjoined as a requirement for this, for serving the teacher, etc. Parivrajaka dharmeshu guru upasanadinam kartavyataya shruti smritishu choditatvat.
And a shruti in the smriti, that is enjoinment that even the parivrajaka dharmeshu,
when they describe the dharma of parivrajaka, like manusmriti, etc., so this is what is enjoined. Yajnopavita parityagaha avagandum naiva shakyati anvayaha.
So we do not see how anybody can ever give up this yajnopavita. We do not see how that is. Because for everybody, this is enjoined in one way or the other.
Alright, so scriptures do not give any consent for discarding Shikha, Yajnopavita, etc. This is established. Then says Anagiri, Samprati Praudhim Arudha.
Alright. Now, even accepting your position,
Praudhim Arudha, Vyutthane Vidhim Angikritya.
Let us say that Vyutthaya is a Vidhi, okay? Purupakshi says, okay, accepting your position, that this statement of the Shruti is to be interpreted as a command or enjoinment for renunciation.
Kritya vidhim angi kritya api tathapi. This is Purupakshi says. Dushayati. Who? Purupakshi dushayati. Purupakshi continues further. All that, accepting your position, that is the position of the Vedantin, that this vakya is an enjoyment of sannyasa, then also dushayati, dushayati.
Says footnote 6, yajnopavitadehe parityagam dushayati. Naturally, he finds fault with the discarding of yajnopavita, etc. Even if this statement is interpreted as a command or an instruction for sannyasa, then also giving up yajnopavita, etc. is not right. This is what he says, yadyapi.
Yadyapi Eshanabhya Vyutthanam Vidhiyate Eva Tathapi Putradi Eshanabhya Tisrubhya Eva Vyutthanam Natu Sarvasmat Karmanaha Karmasadhanacha Vyutthanam.
Yadyapi eshanabhya vyutthanam vidhiyate eva. Alright, vyutthaya is understood as a vidhi. So, eshanayaha vyutthaya. So, alright, that this statement definitely says that one must grow out of this eshanas or desires. Accept it.
Even tathapi, putradi eshanabhya tisubhya eva vyutthanam.
Still, all that this statement means is that one must give up all these eshanas, the putraeshana, vittaeshana, lokeshana, these eshanas must be given up, all that. That's all it says. So why do you say a lot of other things? One has to just give up the eshanas. Why do you say that one has to renounce all karma?
Natu sarvasmat karmanah karma sadhana cha vyutthanam.
But this statement doesn't have to be further interpreted, meaning that one has to give up all the karma as well as karma sadhanam, that all of that also has to be given up. How do you say this statement doesn't say that? All the statement says is that one should give up all the desires, and we accept that part.
Then says Anandagiri, Eshanabhya vyutthane sati Eshanatva avisheshat karmanah tat sadhanaccha vyutthanam setchadi idi.
Then we say to him that alright, Eshanabhya vyutthane sati. If you say alright, that you must grow out of, give up the eshanas or desires, Eshanatva avisheshat karmanah, then we say that the karma also is nothing but another aspect of eshanam. Meaning, what is Aishana at this time, or what is desire at one point, alone becomes karma. Karma is no different from Aishana. Karma is nothing but another form of desire. This is what we say. Because no karma or no action can be performed without the desire. And that being the case, karma is nothing but another form of desire. Sarva Aishanatva Avisheshat Karmanaha. That karma is not really different from Aishana because it is another form of Aishana or desire.
Tassa Karmanaha. Tat sadhana cha vittanam setsadi.
And therefore, we say that when you say that one should give up the Aishana, which means that the karma and karma sadhanam also should be given up because karma is nothing but another form of Aishana. And when karma is given up, naturally karma sadhanam also should be given up. So therefore, the discarding of the action and the rituals and the means automatically gets established. Setsadi, meaning they get established. Even though the Shruti may not say that in a given in words, it amounts to that. So naturally he says, alright, go home. That means go home with a scooter. I mean, when you say go home, that means that go home with a vehicle. It amounts to saying that because you can't go home without the vehicle anyway. That being the case, going home meaning taking your vehicle also, you know. Otherwise you asked me to go home, but I did not ask you to take my vehicle. It implies, you know, for that this is what is understood. Similarly also when it is said that you must give up the Aishanas, it means that you must also give up karma because how can there be karma without Aishana? Unless Aishana is there, karma cannot be there. So giving up Aishana also means giving up karma. Iti Ashankya.
Then, Yajnopavita Dehe Aishanatvam Asiddham Dhanapuru Pakshita. Wait a minute.
Yajnopavita etc. are not equivalent to Aishana. So you cannot say that this Yajnopavita etc. is equivalent to Aishana. You can't compare karma sadhana with Aishana.
Iti Ashayana Sarvaiti. So says Vibhashya. Sarva Parityagecha Ashrutam Kritam Syad Shrutam Cha Yajnopavitadi Hapitam Syad. It should be Chra, Chrutam, not Chrutam, but Shrutam.
Sarva Parityagecha. If you interpret the statement meaning that the fellow gives up all karma and all the karma sadhanam, ashrutam krutam syat, ashrutam yajnopavitadhe parityajanam kalpitam syat. So what the Shruti does not say is what you are doing.
Shrutam cha yajnopavitadhe
hapitam syat, tektam syat, and you are, so this amounts to saying, this amounts to doing this, that you are doing something the Shruti does not say, and you are doing something that Shruti, and you are not doing something that Shruti says, and doing something that Shruti does not say.
And this is a tremendous dosha. That's what Anandaki says. Ashruta karane, shruta tyage cha, akurvan vihidam karma, ityadi shruti masritya dushanamaha. Akurvan vihidam karma, ninditam cha, so samacharan.
So not doing what the Shruti enjoins, and doing something that Shruti prohibits, all of these are looked upon as great doshas. And here, when you say, or when you tell your disciples, you are telling everybody, give up karma, and give up all karma sadhana, yajnopavita, shikha, everything you give up, that means that you are asking people to do something that Shruti wants them to do, and you are, I mean, doesn't want them to do. And you are asking them to give up something that Shruti wants them to retain. And so, that means that you are actually doing something, or anybody who does it, he actually violates, there is a tremendous violation of the scriptures.
So, tathacha, says here, Bhashya, tathacha, mahanaparadha, vihita akarana, pratishiddha acharana nimittah kritasyad.
Tathacha, in doing that, mahanaparadha kritasyad, it would be a great aparadha. A great violation or a great aparadha means a fault, you know, so tremendous fault will be there.
Vidakarana pratishiddha acharana nimittaha. Vidakaranam, not doing something that is enjoined, pratishiddha acharanam, and doing something that is prohibited, this is what it will amount to, and therefore that will be a great dosha.
So great sin it will be.
Then we say, Nanu drishyate yajnopavitadi lingatyagaha.
But we find people doing it. We ask him. But we do find people actually cutting off the shikha and giving up the Agnopavita. This is drishyate. Something you have to see happening in many places. Sa kasman nirakriyate. So why are so many people doing it? The fact that people are doing it, which means that there must be some basis behind it. And here you are saying that there is no basis. So kasman nirakriyate. Sanyasinam. So, lingatyagaha sanyasinam sah kasmad nirakriyate. So how can you overlook that? Tatraha tasmadadi. Then the Purupakshi says, tasmad yajnopavitade linga parityagaha andha parampara eva. Just because some people do does not make it right, he says, you know, tasmad, therefore. Sarvatha yajnopavitadehe parityaga ayogad. In no way can you justify the giving up of the yajnopavita shikha and all of that. And therefore, yajnopavitade linga parityaga. Therefore, discard yajnopavita, all this linga, all the chinha. Andha parampara, if people do it, it is nothing but andha parampara. It is blind following the blind. Parampara means what? Following. Blind following the blind. That's all it is. So therefore, these fellows, as good as mlecha, ultimately these fellows are born in Hindu dharma, and asking them to do something that is totally contrary, violates the dharma. And so no different from other people, you know. So yavana and mlecha, etc., you know. Andha parampara. So today also you'll find many orthodox people strictly and strongly believing that taking this, renouncing, renunciation is definitely wrong. They will not accept it. So renunciation is not accepted by many karmakandis. Particularly in South, and you know, even in North also you'll find. Alright, so this is a Purupaksha. Then says, na iyam andha parampara yati pariharati. He says, wait a minute, this is not andha parampara. Na ityadina. Says Vashakara, that's a he quoted statement. The other statement you can quote, that is one wonderful thing about the Indian scriptures, you know. That you can always quote whatever, so you find something to support whatever you want to say. Ultimately you want Garuda Purana, you know, something you will be able to get, you know. So many Puranas are there, Puranas are there, Itihas are there, so Shrutis and other Shrutis, 18 Shrutis and many other Shrutis are there, and so many statements of Shrutis, so somewhere you will find something which will be able to, by which you can support whatever you want to say. And so Parihadana Ityadina, so Vashyakala says. Na yajnopavitam vedamscha sarvam tadvarjaye dyatihe iti shrutehe. This katha shruti seems to be now quite prevalent, you know. Bhashyakara is actually resorting to that. This also from katha shruti. So, na yajnopavitam vedamscha sarvam tadvarjaye dyatihe. Yajnopavita and Veda also. Veda means only Veda, dhyana, which is a duty. Giving a Veda doesn't mean that discarding Vedas or not respecting Vedas, meaning that giving up the Veda, dhyana, or recital of Veda, which is enjoined as a duty. So recital of the Veda is enjoined as a duty for brahmachari and for grahastha and for vanaprastha, I guess also. For all of them, Veda, dhyana is a duty. And that duty he need not perform. So, yajnopavitam vedamsa sarvam tad varjaye yatihi yati vara sannyasi should give up all of them. It is shrutehi. Says Anandagiri, brahmacharyadeva pravrajet ityadi vidhi upalambhebi. Then footnote number 8, gruhadva vanadva iti shruti sheshaha. Brahmacharyadeva pravrajet gruhadva vanadva. So one may renounce from brahmacharya itself, or from grihastha-ashrama, or from vanaprastha-ashrama. Because vairagya is a qualification, and not whether you are a brahmachari or a grihastha or a vanaprastha, that is not the qualification of sannyasa. The qualification of sannyasa is renunciation. Vairagya as well as jignyasa, desire for knowledge. So whenever that happens, so one can renounce. So brahmacharyadeva pravrajayityadi vidhi upalambhepi. Footnote number 9. Upalambhepi sannyasa vidhayaka yathoktadi vakyantara, vakyantara sattvevi. See, earlier vakyas will be found in the karmakanda section. These vakyas are all found in Upanishads, you know. So sannyasa vidhayaka yathoktadi Vakyandara Sattvevi. That means there are other Vakyas. Just as you find Vakyas where a Parivrajaka also is supposed to do things, here are the definite Vakyas where Parivrajaka is supposed to do nothing. Different kind of Parivrajaka is. Idea is that sannyasa is taken as a chatursa ashrama. Then there are some these duties are there. But if sannyasa is taken as a means of knowledge, then it is a different kind of kartavya. This is the main point here. The sannyasa taken in a due course, because now you have reached a certain age and you want to die as a sannyasi, and then you have certain value for that kind of a life, then various things are enjoined there. But here if the sannyasa is taken purely for knowledge, then even those enjoyments are not there. And so, iti vidhi upalambhevi praudhvadena atmajnana vidhivadeva sannyasam sadhetu iti upalambhevi. So, praudhvadena, see footnote number 10, praudhvadena iti, tathacha vastutaha vithayati na sannyasa vidhayakam praudhya eva tasya vidhiparatvam sadhyate iti bhavaha. That means that actually the vidhanam is not there, as we said. It is an assertion on the part of this Siddhanta here that this vithaya means it is an enjoyment actually. It doesn't literally mean that. So, upalambhevi praudhvadena atmajnana vidhivaladeva sannyasam sadhetum. In fact, Bhashyakara quoted statements from other Upanishads also where this sannyasa is enjoined for the one who has vairagya. But Bhashyakara does not resort even to those vakyas. But praudhvadena, even though those vakyas are available, instead of quoting them, praudhvadena, by a bold assertion, atmajnana vidhivaladeva, because of the vidhi of atmajnanam, vidhi anyatano vattehe atmavare drashtavya, shrutavya, mantavya, vidhi dhyasitavya, atmavare drashtavya. That atma must be known, realized. This is looked upon as a vidhi, that there is a common enjoyment, that you must know the self. And so, know the self meaning what? Do whatever is required in order to know the self. It is not that there is a vidhi with reference to knowledge. That, as we know, knowledge is always vastu-tantram, not purusha-tantram, and therefore, nobody enjoins that you must know atma in a certain way. It doesn't say that, may you know atma as such and such, may you know atma. But you cannot know atma unless you do something that is required to, that knowledge to take place. So, shrotavya, mantavya, nidhyasitavya. You must do shravanam, mananam, nidhyasanam, and then alone you can know atma. So, atma vara drashtavya is the vidhi. It is actually an enjoyment for knowing the atma. So, atmajnana vidhipaladeva, that vidhi is there very clearly. So, on the strength of that vidhi, Vashyakara wants to show that sannyasa is something that is a must.